rabies virus is probably one of the most evil, sinister viruses there, and we've got to stop it. So thank goodness we have the tools, rabies immune globulin, which is sort of the perfect antidote. It binds up the virus.
Human rabies immune globulin, or HRIG, provides rapid immune coverage indicated for post-exposure prophylaxis, PEP, along with rabies vaccine for anyone previously unvaccinated and suspected of exposure to rabies. During this short video, we will explain what occurs during the HRIG manufacturing process. Manufacturing begins with the collection of plasma from healthy donors who have already been repeatedly immunized with rabies vaccine. This repeated immunization allows those donors to develop rabies antibodies. After collection, each plasma donation is tested before being pooled. The HRIG is isolated from the pooled plasma of healthy, hyperimmunized donors through a series of purification steps that maintain its functionality and help to remove or inactivate viruses. First, during a process called cold ethanol fractionation, ethanol and an acid are added to the plasma and maintained at a low temperature. This causes the plasma components and other proteins to precipitate, meaning that they solidify and separate from the liquid. The resulting solution undergoes two rounds of additional purification treatment to further facilitate the removal of impurities. The second round, the incubation step, removes or inactivates contaminating viruses. Then, a process called anion exchange chromatography is used to isolate immunoglobulin G, or IgG, antibodies from other protein impurities. Finally, after a series of filtration steps, the manufacturing process has significantly reduced impurities in the HRIG.
Rabies immune globulin is used in that post-exposure setting to provide the immediate protection, trying to get that preventative treatment in right away. Because what you don't want to do is let this virus do its dirty work.
Rabies is essentially 100% fatal if not treated promptly and correctly. Learn more at rabieswatch.com.